Dirtmap und Firestorm joins.
It's Destiny.
Ja. Or it's Desert Car. Panas, probably not. By Jabski, yeah. My favorite cover of the day, Matter. Hm?
Looks like a dirt map.
Ja, Shadow Cleanser, unlucky. No big abyss. Yeah, probably gonna be a very normal map. Lingo offer time, yeah. So AT cooked, okay, good to know. So we're probably gonna have a good GPS.
Not a lot of outside turns.
It just crashed in one, exactly.
Yeah,
when
it was just now one, yeah.
Good race, Fedor. It also crashed it, by the way.
Sausage feels so much better.
Exactly. We are always at the same spot. Yeah. Also I respawned now multiple times and maybe not anymore. Okay, yeah, you have to go super outside actually in the sausage.
Not that easy to get the sausage.
Release once in that up eternity, you lose the gear. Wait.
Yeah, same as always with these turns.
They weren't like that in TM2.
Yeah, because they were bumpy as shit. Like everything on dirt.
No, but keeping the gear was easier.
But were you but then the fourth gear?
No, yeah, it was the fourth gear, it was not the fourth gear.
I don't know.
Yeah,
100%. I'm pretty sure I do know. I can grip the inside in the ending. Yeah, AT is looking rather juicy.
54, you say? Yeah.
Get a freeze, finally.
I'm still waiting for it. Just saw this.
So funny, when you start your game and boot it up, I have it open for 10 hours already. And Corgi, thank you for the tier 2 29 month resub. Thank you very much for the good luck.
How's World Cup going?
Pretty good so far, but you really need to invest time if you want to have a chance. But I learned all maps already, played like one full map so far, but I also got a pretty good time on, I would say, for now at least. But pretty interesting maps.
Yeah,
I
watched
a lot of
YouTube
tricks
videos.
Well.
I watched the Secrets map, that's quite interesting. Huh?
Yeah, but that one's probably gonna be a pace map. There's not a lot you can do there in terms of tricks, like a little bit, but
yeah.
I mean, on the Dank map here, spin-off by Whiskey, there's obviously a lot of things you can do.
Yeah, this one I still have to watch.
Yeah. If I've never seen it yet, then probably... it'll also be like Omega Lul.
When is the qualifier again?
6th and 7th of October.
1.5 weeks.
Ah, okay. It's actually more time than I thought.
The problem is that Granati cannot play Arm X again.
In that one day you can make free. I mean, it's a good break, of course. Finally, my freeze arrived. It took so long. Like, it's always like I have 2-3 minutes of build-up of my game just lagging until I finally can play.
So weird, actually. What are my opinions on the maps now after learning them? The Castlemania is boring as fuck. I don't know why, like, it's just so much worse than the other maps, like... feeling a little bit sad for building that, because the map itself is not like terrible or anything, but it's just so like standard and not exciting, and yeah, I don't know. Not sure why that map is in. But aren't that
one map with close races, but...
yeah, but you can also have close races on exciting maps, like...
yeah.
Some of the XPBO maps are so much better and we will also have close races for sure. At least that one is quite long. That is good, but...
yeah, I'm just thinking that that was probably the intention.
Yeah, probably. But pretty tricky and gonna be hard to be regular on these. And it's also like perfect maps like that could have been played in a league, you know? Like that you could play over multiple weeks and keep improving and improving. It's actually sad that like some of the best maps of the entire year, at least in Trackmania World Tour, are only gonna be played by... you know, a minority of players and... wait a second, I have to focus, I'm on PB. And, yeah, you know, you only play them for a tiny little bit. How the hell am I pointing... am I 1 second behind? I'm watching TPS. That's a cooked AT. Doesn't even say the AT time, I just hope it's...
look good.
Aha, small nose light. No slide I saw, I didn't really like, to be honest. Yo, good luck, Landon. Good luck, good luck, good luck. Yeah, I mean, looks good, but nothing crazy. Just normal lines and one nose slide. That is probably not gaining a lot.
I'm gonna watch it again. Last time I was watching the GPS, I had a bunch of freezes in between, so...
I don't like the nose slide, guys. What's the outside dirt entry? not sure if I'm safe yet. I mean, I have a 0.89. Which lets me assume that I am. Technically, I can easily improve.
I thought this was now absolutely safe, but no. Why did I only improve by 2/10? That was a bit.
Like, I've watched the GPS, and I have literally no clue how I'm losing more than a second to that. Like, what the hell? It's weird to me, this map.
Okay, save. 53. Suck first. Nyko, the dirt abuser. Yeah.
Also happy with my run. I don't know where to improve it. It was kind of good everywhere.
Scheiße, no cut, Mann.
Oh, bad.
At least nothing obvious. Checkpoint placement, too good. Nee, 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 nee. And now London, thank you for the tier 1 sub. Appreciate it. And Corgi also, thank you for the 20. Ah, nee, I said thank you to you, Corgi, never mind. Fuck, purple beat me. Really mad. That's like a, yeah, there's like a lot of small nose lights you could maybe do, but like, good luck to the AT hunters. Glad I'm not one of them. Okay, naja, this one in the start actually gains more than 0.1. Yes, Beowulf.
I hate this map. Oh my god. Oh no, I don't get it. And then the gear, like in that upper at the very end, deciding the entire run. So annoying.
Ah, man.
I really wonder how much I actually lost with that gear there. Like, the rest of the run was pretty good. Can be like 2/10 ahead, but
Mann, das Noselight ist ass.
Fuck this gear, honestly.
Oh yeah.
Is it enough?
Bye bye.
Bye.
Yeah, bye bye.
Maybe I get it without the gear, I don't know, I just couldn't get the gear. I got an 89, maybe it's enough.
Ooh, I'm in!
Yeah.
For sure lost like 2/10 at least with not getting the gear probably more.
We have an 89 loss. That's what Granati had earlier. Actually. Yeah.
But you both have an 89?
Yeah, you had an 89,
yeah.
And now Lars has an 89.
Also. I thought you as
and
well.
You wondered if it's safe. And it seems to be safe. Yeah. Through the Marius for once. I didn't believe in it on this map.
Yeah, these uphills are always the same. Like they're also so often on like competitive maps, but it's just always like go tight, your entry decides everything, just survive, it's like.
Wait, that is
literally it. Okay, got it.
Okay, I didn't play any Track of the Day for a week besides one, and that was the Frisbee map. Great.
But we all made it, except for Firestorm.
And he's not in the core anymore, so we can say we all made it.
Yup. Yeah, but so easy to touch here, to not survive a run. I don't know. These Georgia pills, like usually you don't have to be like Giga outside, but if you release, you're in the mud. That's basically it. Like, get a line without release and you keep the gear. As long as it's somewhat outside.
I think I did actually release.
Yeah, you can also make
a
release, but that definitely increases your chance of getting the gear down.
Yeah.
I mean, I got the gear down because I had to release. It was either crash or release.
I improved a lot towards my previous PB in the last sector, probably because I took the grip on the ring.
Yeah, like, this is really fun. I'm in front of you, Granati, until the upper.
Yeah.
Wait. And I was almost not the one.
I could gain 0.16 or so in the start, but I have no idea how to be like half a second faster. That's crazy. I mean, okay, I know like one or two more parts, but this is cheaper. Crazy time.
Will you play the Seconds to Go campaign and stream, Granati?
Yeah, but I don't know when. So busy with Roadshow right now. I don't know if I have time until that's done.
Well, I was planning to do it today, but now Virtual is doing it today as well, and I'm like, I don't know if I want to then. Probably do something else.
I'm gonna probably be the very last one playing it.
Probably at least I will have good.
There's of course also a competition on it, but you'll probably play it then when the competition is already over.
Yeah, and don't care too much about that. World Tour just is sadly more important. Yeah, hello, it's a release. Oh, God.
Oh, this has also potential again for 55. How are all the maps either 55 or 44 seconds long?
That's crazy.
On one track that you guys missed, that was on the Volvic Cup day, someone had, I think, a 101.111. But I had also such times. 101. 101.
That's gonna be so easy to, in the later round, touch the outside there and then just be like, out.
Apropos once, literally your track, Granati, in the Seconds to Go campaign, as we were just talking, someone made a screenshot in the Discord.
Yeah.
How he got an 11.111 on your track.
Oh.
He asked if he should improve that. And I said he should wait until he's dropped to 11th and then make another screenshot.
The ATs are just automatically set to the second we have, right?
No.
Also,
that's your time.
Did you not drive that 11.000?
No.
Wow, cheated all the time.
Yeah, it was faster.
Needed to cheat. first
Femi J quit the seconds to go campaign on Mario's map. Wasn't Mario's map 2 or something?
4.
4.
I saw he spent like half an hour trying to get the other time on Shorty's map and then quit.
I actually didn't hunt my OT too much. Like, just went for a clean run.
On mine he didn't even try to beat the AT. And then Mario's, yeah,
was already was gold difficult or
yeah.
But I checked Villa in his VOD, he actually got pretty quick on my map, he got into gold very quick. I also don't understand, I mean last you saw my replay on my map, how perfect it is, like optically. And then now someone has an 82, 700s ahead. It's really hard to understand.
Need to see if he did anything different.
Yeah, it's the same strat. Everyone does the same strat. So it seems like this one is probably the fastest, or nobody tries the air. Like, this is also the easiest strat to do. So everyone is just going for that, and then it seems to be also fast. But yeah, it must be the turnaround, kind of, from backwards into forwards. It must be something there where he doesn't lose as much speed.
Your map is hella fun, a timing-based minigame in Trackmania, yeah, thank you, glad you like it. I think it's also pretty cool.
Crazy that it's 700s.
And hello, Matt.
I think it was also beaten now by 7000s though. 4 people have beaten the AT on my map now. But yeah, I doubt that there's much more possible looking at it.
But there is an unbeaten AT by an OK boy that will probably remain unbeaten. Also,
yeah, but that's
requires
unfair.
Certain. It requires some very special players to beat that.
And I'm a little bit tired today, and this map really does not help. Oh, I've touched twice. And then lost the gear because of the touch, and lost another gear because of the touch. Kept the ending gear though, does that matter?
I lost it.
Hey, PB.
It did actually matter, I did overtake by getting the gear at the end.
Monka.
Ah, god. But yeah, 2 touches plus 2 gears lost is not very good.
Yeah, my name is Richard. I was kinda tired today, to be honest. Probably because last few days I played so much Trackmania, it's like... Actually,
I don't know why I'm so tired.
Oh, first time message, Lars keeps yapping. Yeah.
Okay.
Lars interview? Why are you yapping?
Yeah, why should I answer? I'm just yapping then. Yeah, I'm just...
True.
Okay, I'll just shut up. Okay.
Who is the new winner today? Also, I think there will be no new winner on this map.
Ah, this will be some classical win.
Okay, I'm actually confused. I've been barely talking. What do you mean? I'm so tired. I've been barely talking. What are you talking about? Specifically today.
Actually, today I also don't get it.
Oh, ich hab Problem mit, I have problems with that turn.
This year is so hard, this turn for me. You got the nice entry after as well.
Ah, nice. If you lose the gear, this one part, you are in lower gear for like 1 year. Ah, I lost my gear, I might be out.
Oh, G.
But I'm actually out. What the fuck? Heh? Bro, I'm literally out because I had gear issues of Doom.
Yeah.
Oh my god, no.
Last run was a little bit slower. There were 2 seconds in orange and yellow. The run before was already 1 point, I believe.
I had one small touch that gave me like the touch didn't lose me a lot, but I got gear free, couldn't get it back for 10 seconds, did like releasing in every single turn to not get gear down. And then I also touched the apple and also not touched the apple, but I lost the gear there as well. Again. Like I got it back right before and then I lost it again. Fantastic. Amazing. I love piss easy maps. And 55 seconds long and only a 1 second gap for being in this chapters.
Yeah, this map must be also really annoying, like for specifically like Div 2, Div 3. Because like, if we already struggle with the gears, then yeah.
Yeah, I mean the gears themselves, the uphill is definitely hard to keep. Other than that, you just need to not touch. But there's so many like walls you have to go close to.
Yeah, but that's also from us as Div 1 players. Like there's always, there's gotta be always that threshold, that specific division where they're exactly have the pace where the gears are horrible. Where you just about can get them, but it's very hard.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, many people struggle with these outside turns, though.
How much do I lose with that gear? Your 6 cents, cool.
This is just always so hard to see, eh?
What do you think about this round, Carnati, after you went out?
No, fantastic. Never lucky. Classic, 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 classic.
Bonus playing. Thanks for the raid, I cannot look right now, but thanks. This map sadly has no straights.
Nah, wooden floor, I joined as a spectator. It's a new feature that Nadeo added, and when you don't get good enough in the seeding, you can still join as a spectator for the streamer so that you can spectate this one. It's actually a cool feature.
Uh-oh. Lost the gear. I'm out.
Yeah.
I only got 8 for the 0.5.
Okay. Man, oh man, this one gear loss, like just barely. And I dropped so much. Erotic vows. Yo, thanks.
What's after Kappa? Maybe some more unbeaten snow AT hunt. But maybe I will also just end and because I don't know why, like I didn't even feel tired the entire day, but now that I started streaming it's kinda I don't think it really was because I played so much DM the last 2 weeks. Like not 2 weeks, but like few days. Like on Saturday we had the big Volvic charity race, the big Volvic duo dash. Where I did around, like 1 hour of mapping, then 2 hours of YouTube before, and then 8 hours of streaming. So that was giga exhausting. And then now Sunday and Monday, I did like, 6 to 7 hours of Trickmania World Tour practice each day. Like learning the maps with Massa, driving a bit of full map, and then also each day before, a little bit of YouTube work that had to be done. Small stream on Monday yesterday as well, 2 hours, like this jeepers. I mean, he's cooking a 0.20.
Pretty lucky, Kanshika.
Okay.
Da kann auch die. Wir müssen anlocken.
Jo. Unfortunate. Can happen. That one was the
serve. So, what are you thinking? Spam going out this round?
What
are you thinking? Me going out because I just got it out.
Oh my god, spam could have been so fucking in the mud. He went so much over the edge. Kanadi censoring? No. I'm not censoring.
Let's see, Lars. You already have 3.
Okay.
So, you only need one more. But they are of course still close to you, so you can also drop them back. Oh, there are multiple. Spam actually is behind you.
Not anymore.
Spam might be in front. No, Spam is still behind you. Spam could be out you as well.
Ah, Spam is gonna survive.
Must be a bad one. Oh my god, that's
gets
my
one,
third
Sarko
touch in one run.
And gear down, and Spam has it.
That was just good grip from him.
Rip Bozo.
Oh,
rip to the Bozo, rip to the Bozo. I don't know why,
probably
but I did it. I don't think there has ever been a Japski map where I was like, oh my god, holy shit, insane.
Yeah,
like his maps are always
good. This is...
This map is also good, like I liked it, but now I'm like pissed by the map. Maybe because I went on early. I would really love to see someone like Japski, who's like really good at driving, at building like you know, normal maps. Try to build something like more advanced, like not necessarily like giga dank shit with flips, backslides or whatever, but like something like more complex, difficult. I don't know.
Like,
I mean, this is already honestly this is already
is
a step upwards though. Like usual Japski maps are even easier.
I think the problem with this map is that it's actually like, I mean, it is kind of easy when it works, but when anything doesn't work, it's incredibly difficult. This map, like it is, it looks way easier than it actually is, this map. Like, it's a hard map, but it looks incredibly easy, and I think that's what makes it kind of annoying, frustrating.
Yeah. I don't worry,
guys.
It's
also like, it doesn't take too long to find, like, the correct sweat. Yeah, Kachik, go with the gear down.
Yeah, he crashed also on the uphill.
Rip. Don't worry, guys,
soon
my map is gonna
be
tough.
If you crash in the uphill, then you...
Surely.
Crash on the upper, get the gear down after as well. It's great.
Yeah, why shouldn't it make a pickle? Just a cooked run. Yeah, it's definitely cooked. It's by Lingo, apparently. Let me actually check. What are the Discord ratings? Discord ratings, quick check after half an hour. We're going in.
Wait, we are only at top 22? I thought we were like top 10 or something.
What? Okay, rankings. Yeah, pretty good, pretty good. Basically 10 votes. Like very average. Sort of. 27 plus votes. Yeah, it's definitely like around this, I would say. I don't know why people vote triple minus here, but it's always the case, so...
But give this map a heli car, that would be very different.
Yeah, would be very better.
I think actually I would have enjoyed it more.
If you say that. Actually, in 1 week, we're already gonna have the new season. And Adeo didn't tease anything yet. As always, actually. Actually, why am I surprised?
Yeah.
It's always like this. Like, trust me, guys,
a conversation
like...
from Hydus on Twitter actually lately. He answered randomly on some post from or Sneaky Annie or something. Someone?
Nina.
Yeah.
Nina Dor.
Nina,
okay.
Now he said that the new campaign is also gonna have alt cars. Gonna be interesting.
Which is great. Why?
Yeah. Yeah, like I mean, I guess it makes
number
sense
one feedback was to not do
yeah,
that.
That's true.
Like if it's just, if it's a little bit, it's maybe okay. If it's multiple maps again, then honestly, what the fuck are they doing? Like,
yeah, I guess
why
it's
do we
I guess there's going to be like a little bit of desert rally and snow. I guess it's because it was this year, you know, it was the plan for this year all along.
Yeah. If it's a little bit, I think it's fine. You know?
My question is,
not
is there
going to
be
one again?
Yeah. The thing is, like, the entire year next to... We always had something big with the update. Not only new campaign, but also, like, you know, like, stun mode or new car or shit like that. So we'll see.
But I found interesting,
I wonder
someone
what it could
was
be.
Asking... Someone was asking Hylas if he cannot give an answer, like, what's happening in future, what are their plans, what are they working on, and Hylas meant something like, he's afraid that he makes them promises, and when they don't work, then everyone is disappointed, so he rather doesn't say anything beforehand. So this is how I understood it.
That is so stupid.
Yeah.
I don't know, but
like, they don't get any feedback, and then, like, It would have been probably an improvement if they would have told us what they were planning with stunt mode, that everybody could have told them instantly, like this the stupidest idea I've ever seen.
Yes. The thing is like, why is it... Huh? Why is, are your splits on the left also fucked up?
No.
Look on my stream, for me it says Kanchika is currently in red. And everybody has plus
30. We are in the top 18 round.
Yeah, for me it shows top 26. Fantastic! Wait, let me do rejoin currently.
Yeah, it also doesn't show the correct round for you. We are now going into round 13.
No,
And it showed for you round 10.
I saw that spark as well already, and like sometimes it randomly happens. It's interesting that it doesn't happen to everyone.
Okay. Maybe it was because I tapped out or something, I don't know. But the thing is like, how does Nadeo not have, like they must have a roadmap sort of thing, where they like internally say, yeah, we're gonna work, these are the plans for the next year. I mean, okay, it's Nadeo, maybe they don't have it, and they decided like 1 month before, you know. But technically how it should be is that they have a roadmap. And they could just like publicly announce what their plans are, and if they for some reason have to, you know, change up the plans and say like, yeah, this and this feature we cannot add, then just say that public, say why, and everybody's gonna understand it, you know? But like, there's nothing worse to say than not saying anything. I don't know why Nadeo is so fucking yek when it comes to communication. In some parts at least. Like, I don't get it.
I am so afraid. I am so afraid that they will release a puzzle mode as a new game mode and completely fuck it up.
I'm pretty sure they will do at some point.
And we'll just use the Open Planet plugin instead. Like, I don't know. Like, I don't know. I'm afraid of that. Like, they have to fuck it up if they try. I don't know. They don't see a way that they could make it better than the Open Planet plugin made by one guy, you know?
I was jinxing Hayom a little bit in my head. I just thought, if we want a new winner, I think Hayom has the best chances, and no, he's out of. I mean, he had to deny me, of course. Someone said it also in my chat yesterday, in the, after the Yak Cup. Hayom got these 15,000 points for nothing, because he didn't participate in any other cup, but he denied me now. So dumb.
Yeah, like they will definitely add plat. I mean, now that they started, why should they not add platform and puzzle at some point? Nadeo is just so good at being like ecologically. They are honestly the best recycling company in the entire market.
That's a good round. I mean, Max Hawk is surely not super slow, and he is out with that.
The thing is, didn't even like. I think somebody said also that stunt mode is gonna be changed for the update. And gonna be improved.
Hmm.
Not sure if how or like if that's actually the case, but
so I also heard
Ender. I think Ender did it on Ender said that on my Discord. True. Yeah, we will see. We will see. We will see. I mean, the way to improve stunt mode is basically delete stunt mode and bring back old stunt mode. Like it would have been no work and it would have been better. It's actually fantastic. Yeah, Ender often knows this shit, so very likely that stunt mode is gonna be updated, but like how though? Like it's just gonna be some yak update, core mode is still gonna be the same and still nobody will give a fuck, I'm pretty sure.
I mean, you would have to throw out everything that they did before. Okay, I got myself an apple and a Volvic bottle that says awake on it, surely that would help. I got another package by the way.
Wait, really? I got mine 2 days ago.
Yeah, I got.
I don't know why you go.
Package with like four bottles, and the other one was then for the big yak.
Ah, okay.
Cup, I guess.
Yeah, like so I got the one with four.
Yeah, I got in total like 16 bottles now. Something.
By how many? You should have gotten three packages, right? Or maybe it was three. It was. So if the other one was 12, maybe it was 3x4 then. I guess.
Yeah, I guess so.
Mm. Yeah, okay.
What's in the BYMC pack? Was like 12 bottles. Two big ones and then 10 smaller ones.
I thought it was gonna be more actually. Let me quickly check something.
Was short D not here?
I was, to be honest, I was also expecting more, but I don't know what I would do with more, even more water.
Yeah, I mean, sending Volvic is like kind of difficult because like the weight to being worth ratio is like, like if it was Red Bull, like you know, a can of Red Bull is costing more than a Volvic bottle and it's way less. Way, you know what I mean. Nah, it's not water. Warwick has like different stuff, like water with like taste, iced tea, all of that kind of stuff. It's like a mix of everything, not just plain water. I don't think plain water is that, part of it. That would be.
There was
be
very one. To be honest. Plain there was one water bottle.
Ah, so now okay, that's fair, normal. I guess. Yeah, I mean, I also didn't know what's like. I didn't know what's gonna be in those until. Until you basically sent me the picture of yours. I also asked Big like multiple times, but it was nobody really knew what's gonna be in there, so I also couldn't say it in the things. But next month is gonna... Guys, did you guys, by the way, see it? The next month, Big Kick Monthly Cup was not announced yet, but we're gonna have a special edition where you guys can submit your maps. I don't even know if you have seen it yet. I didn't mention it on stream yet. But all of you guys can send maps which might be used in the Big Kick Monthly Cup. So kind of Bonk Cup style, but you can submit anything. Can be like dank maps, can be normal maps, can be full speed, can be dirt, can be snow car, can be anything you absolutely want. The requirements are on my Discord though, so I can maybe show it to you real quick while we are, ignoring the round. So check out this post here in hashtag news in Big Kick Monthly Cup category. Here you see the requirements and also the link to upload the things through. So if you want to send in your map and it might be played in the Big Kick Monthly Cup, then make sure to join my Discord and check this out, guys. And I mean, if your map is played in one of the editions, you can still play it though. So it's even a little bit of a bonus you can work for. The only thing is that for the monthly final, I will of course make sure that none of the maps being used in monthly final were built by any of the 20 participants, because that would be very unfair. But in the qualifiers, you might have a small bonus then. Yeah, I think I will do...
Good round there.
Yeah, I didn't pay attention.
Yeah, it was top 7, like 0.6 went out. So
okay.
Everybody within 210.
Also, everybody 0.3 to 0.5 PB so far. Oh, Novu's small nose light here. But only doing it earlier than the other one from the GPS. Huh. Gonna do some more unbeaten snowcar ATs after this. I think I'm gonna do a little bit more. I think if I would have still been in Cup of the Day, I would have been like super exhausted by now. But since I'm just chilling for half an hour, hello? I should be fine.
Lars Granati, I cannot hear you. I cannot hear any sound since I went into the kitchen. I don't know what's happening. Just saying that you don't want her.
Dick. Marius be like, yek POV. Marius POV, yek.
I don't know why he had to tell us that he's in his kitchen right now. Like, but how does he even speak to us?
I don't know. Mike sends up to 500%. Fucking Marius, man. Kinda funny, to be honest. Kinda funny. What is the Big Yak warm-up time usually? I want to make a risky part that people can try and warm-up to fuck with them. So the way the warm-up works in Big Yak Monthly Cup is always that the warm-up is basically infinite, and once the first person finishes, there's like a 5-second cooldown. Which is actually pretty cool, because that also gives an advantage to warm-up heroes, basically. So to people who read the map instantly, they can instantly finish and have an advantage over the others. Because the others perhaps haven't seen the entire map yet. I think that makes the most sense, because having like a static warm-up of like 40 seconds is kind of difficult when maps are sometimes 10 seconds long and sometimes they are like 50 seconds long, so yeah. Hello Kanadi, preparing for a hurricane today, Preach. Ach du Kacke. Where are you living? I guess you're not talking about the festival, so I wish you the best of luck. But sounds like America. Florida, yeah, of course. It's always so funny that like the continent with the most kind of hurricanes and typhoons and all of that kind of shit has like the worst houses for that kind of stuff. Like from a European POV, it's like, you know, if like a hurricane would come in here, as long as it's not the strongest one ever, like the houses would be like, it would not matter at all. Like, the houses would just be, like, stable. Like, you know?
Yeah, like, it's so weird when you see videos of American houses where people, like, punch a wall and their fist just goes through the wall.
Yes, like in Germany,
are your walls
Germany,
made out of paper mache or what?
It literally is, though. It is like paper walls.
Like
it is, don't you crazy. Also hear everything through the doors? Like, if you have, like, I don't know. Like, imagine I visit your mama in America. And then late night, you wake up because you hear everything. Isn't that like super weird? Yes? Okay. American houses, literally plastic and paper. Okay. Yeah, but that's like so weird. Like, why are they not building the houses properly? I'm so confused. It's so less likely a flying brick won't destroy you if there is a hurricane. What? So less likely if... Yeah, but like, instead of a flying prick, you will get slammed by an entire house that's flying away. Is that much better? I mean, like, hurricanes are not suddenly appearing out of nowhere. Like, meteorologists, Mario's work people, they can predict them, like, multiple days before. Like, just stay at home or stay somewhere safe while it's there. I mean, it's also not taking, like... 5 days until the hurricane is gone, no? Isn't it always, like, rather short? I don't know. Like, from a European POV, it's just all kind of weird. Not gonna lie. I mean, I once heard someone say, like, if the houses would be more expensive, like, more properly built, it would be more expensive to rebuild them. But, like, the idea is that you don't have to rebuild them at all.
Yeah, the... Why do they want to rebuild them? Because rebuilding costs money, you know? So they get more...
It's like an investment.
People building them... Yeah, exactly. Like, it's the exact same thing as with, I don't know, printers or something. Like, they also have to break after a couple of years, so you buy a new printer. Okay, maybe not the best example, but you get what I mean. Like, stuff becomes brittle. So that you have to buy it again. Otherwise, you know, like, look at Tupperware. Like, their shit is way too good, now they're bankrupt, because nobody buys something new, because,
You buy it once in 1992, and then you have it for the rest of your life. That's true. Oh, nein, what is this? Okay. Copypasta from Iridium. I have an issue. My girlfriend of 6 months have gotten so accustomed to your voice that she needs your stream on when she's sleeping. It's gotten so far now because she won't even have sex if your stream is not on in the background. It used to be Family Guy, but come on, man. Yeah, understandable. Or it's maybe the Lars yapping in the background, which turns her on. Never know. Possible as well.
Understandable, honestly.
Yeah. Oh, grand final, by the way. I'm so not focused.
Good start to the grand final.
I'm so very unfocused. Molle versus Icke. Switzerland versus Sweden. Expensive country versus even more expensive country. Ikewolf 0.3 PB, Molle point... They have the exact same PB, mashallah. They both have 0.325. We're going in. Who's gonna get the better outside? Ikewolf risking it more. Is he gonna have more speed? Yes, he needs the grip. He needs the gorilla grip. Is he gonna grip the gorilla? He's gonna grip the gorilla, but it's not enough speed. It's gonna be Molle with the win. 0.40. GG.
Yeah.
Caster talent. GG. Nice, fun. Okay.
Gets paid for 20 seconds of casting.
Yeah. That makes 200 euro. Send it to my PayPal real quick. Thank you very much. Anyway, Lars, good luck. Ah, nee, you're not playing the campaign. Yeah, good luck with whatever you're doing.
Yeah, I'm doing like viewer challenges.
Oh, so, yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm gonna head out. See you tomorrow then. Bye bye.
See you.